Johnny Watson.
Hey, Bert.
Drummer extraordinaire.
Yes.
Give us the Tubbs rundown.
Tubbs rundown. Yep. At the moment, I'm using my favourite mid-80s Gretsch kit. With a bit of a ring in, a bit of a 90s slingland over here, a bit of a luddy here.
Is this the kit that'll be going on the road for this tour?
No, the kit will be the 90s slingland on the road. And
what's the use of talking to you then?
Hey? And of course, the Vata.
Mm.
The eternal Vata 2B Woods.
Do you endorse those, John?
Ah, oh, look, you know.
Not much.
No. Hardly. And a variation of used, broken, and borrowed cymbals.
Mm.
And that's about it, really.
What's everything?
And your high end Gibraltar.
That's about it, mate.
Yeah.
Bit of Gibraltar hardware.
Give him a belt for us.
No.
Come on.
That forever now, haven't you?
Probably yep, forever and ever.
How do you find that snare? What snare is that?
It's a Ludwig. That's a Ludwig re-release, limited edition, 1,000 only made.
Is that yours?
Yes, mine, Jim.
Well, I didn't know if it was from here.
No, from here.
You'd like a
try
hot
and get a kit from here. Wouldn't have skins on if it was from Deluxe.
Broken and battered.
Well, no, that's us.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
That's the start.
James is here. James.
Well, thanks very much.
Thanks.
James Reyne of the James Reyne Band. Lovely, right. Lovely guitar. Where did that come from?
From our friend Brett up in...
up Newcastle Central
way. Coast, yeah, just near Gosford, who makes them.
That's cool.
The second one I bought from him,
yep.
Thanks to Brett. And they're fantastic. And they play really well, and they're lovely workhorses.
So your preferred amp's the Vox AC30?
The Vox AC30, all the time, all day.
And how do you have it set? Let's get nerdy about it.
Okay, I stick it on top boost.
Yep.
And then, because we're in rehearsal, the volume's down. But treble about there.
Yeah.
More bass from treble for me. So you get that. Now, turn off the reverb, but sometimes, and I do like this feature, I love this bit. So if I want to get John Fogerty, you get that.
Yeah.
The tremolo.
So you just do that manually without a foot switch, yeah?
I don't often use it because it can drive everyone nuts. And then I put it through this thing, which is my little boost pedal. That Brett Kingman put me on too. And then I can put it also through the power. There you
beautiful.
Go, that's my...
that's it, simple and
very technical.
Deadly.
Yeah, it's simple
hey,
and deadly.
Yeah, Phil? How do you know if the wah pedal's on if like, there's no light on?
I don't, because I just wait for someone like Phil Ceberano to remind me in a gig and come and kick it, so it's going... What the f***ing noise?! Phil will come over and go, you got your wah on.
Thanks very much.
Pleasure, thank you.
Yeah. See you. Barani, first and second guitar player for the James Reyne Plays Australian Crawl Tour. I was going to say Rig Rundown, but that actually is owned by Premier Guitar. We'll call it the Gear Rundown. The Rig Rundown. What do you got? What's happening?
Okay. I actually put this pedal board together specifically for the James Reyne Tour last summer, and it's actually going to work really well for this one as well. First thing... is I'm not a gaffer. I'm not a what's it called? Velcro. I'm not a Velcro guy. I like to screw my pedals in, because if I've got Velcro on, then I'm tempted to swap pedals every gig.
So it's a commitment thing.
It's a commitment thing, and then it's also a tone thing, because then you're locked in to what you've got, and you just got to use what you've got. So you're more likely to milk your tone. So. See these little things here? I found these at a guitar shop. They're like a little
butterfly clips.
Yeah, stainless sort of steel thing that screws one into your pedal underneath and then one down.
Cool.
So they're locked in, and it's also kind of flight proof, so that you don't open your case and it's...
So give us a pedal by pedal blow.
Okay, so we've got the Zvex Box of Rock. And this is all relative to the amp I'm using as well. So what we've... This is my at-home amp, which is a Sir Badger 30, which essentially is a, is it a JTM 30 or a, it's kind of like a Marshall basement, original kind of basement head.
Righto.
What's it called? Like a JMP.
JMP?
A JMP.
JTM, sorry.
JTM 30. Yeah?
I'll never remember.
Right, so just straight through. It's clean just with a little bit, just a little bit. When I go to a humbucker. Clean, right?
Yeah, it's good sound.
So what I found is the Zvex box of rock works really well in front of the amp. Just to kind of dirty things up a little bit, just to give it a bit of warm crunch.
Yep.
And then for solos, I just whack on a bit of overdrive on the top of that, which comes from the Zvex. So it's kind of boosting and giving me sustain as well there. Okay. I've got another booster if I want that tone. So that needs a bit of a clean, this one. Can we just pretend we didn't do that? That's a bit fucked!
That's the old Ketlin bred Serrano Picasso. Which I think
needs
it needs
a bit of a fucking swap out.
Yeah, I'd probably chuck it.
Classic blues driver for that sort of.
Cool. Got
original 80s
DM2.
DM2. Yep. Got a kind of rockabilly thing. This cool little hot tone chorus pedal, which is like an $80 worth of pure chorus gorgeousness. Does the trick there.
Yep.
You gave me this, so yep. You can, that's the Lotus.
Lotus Yellow Delay. Really warm tails.
Really.
Very nice, the sort of ambient, kind of warm room.
When I want to get really long delays, I go for this young, again, analog delay sounds.
Yep.
So what I usually use that for is for things like.
Beautiful.
Now this one's a bit of a collector's item. It's the Sherlock Tremant, made locally.
Sherlock is a Melbourne company, is it?
Yeah, and they're no longer made. So that's really quite a classic tremolo.
Nice.
So that works really well when you want to do.
Yeah. Beautiful. That's
and,
nice. And the wah.
The 5-3-5. Which I don't really use much in this game.
Always a classic. No, but it's there.
Good if you, for soloing if you, like if you want to funk boost.
Out. That's great.
Top end. Yes.
Thanks very much, and I see we've got a spare guitar over here, the Charvel San Dimas with what looks like some sort of hex pickup in the back.
Okay.
What's going on there?
So this is the brand new Fishman triple play, it's called, and one of James's songs, of course, is Reckless, and it has a cello part in it, which I will play for you right now. So that's the...
So that's wirelessly running the software on the Mac, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice.
So that's, here's my cellos. I'm blown away by how sensitive it is with the picking.
What's the software under it? Oh, Sample Tank.
Yeah.
Which is an IK multimedia.
That's right.
Software sampler. Beautiful. That's great.
Yeah, and it's also I also use it for a pad.
Excellent. And the old trusty, the trusty old 80 Strat.
Yes.
Eddie, what
1989
is
Strat Plus. And I could spend days taking you through my mod that I've done on this, but it wouldn't take too long. I've got so. On the bridge, I've got a Seymour Duncan
JB, is it?
JB
or 59
humbucker. Push-pull pot here to convert it to single. And that's a universal tone control for all three pickups. And the middle I've had adjusted so that if I wanted to get the front pickup on, almost like a telly kind of sound, I just wind it in.
Beautiful.
So there's that sort of thing. So just it's mainly for the studio if you just want to try different kind of things. If you switch it to those two on, then you've got, and you've got that front pickup wound up, you've got them all on. I was kind of inspired a bit by Brian May,
right,
from Queen.
That's that great. Sort of, and Big Jumbo Frets,
which have been the same ones since its original. So they're worn down quite low, but quite a flat neck. And I've got quite a low action for tuning, not because I'm light in the loafers, but I find that the lower the action, the more tuneful it can be.
That's groovy. Thanks.
All right.
We'll move on.
The thing that they're quoting is...
He's a band five.
Andrew McIvor. Bass player for the James Reyne Plays Australian Crawl Tour.
Music Man 5.
The Music Man.
Stingray 5.
Yeah.
Circa 96. Annie Ball. Green packet of strings.
Speak up, man!
And
oh, it's
Deluxe.
Deluxe custom cables.
20-foot custom cable. Direct from backline. Mark bass. Little Mark 800 tube.
Yep.
Mark bass 410HR.
This is the rig that'll be doing the rounds.
Do I have to commit to that?
Yeah. No. Right.
I'll do one show and then it's gone.
Okay. Yeah. To be replaced by?
Ampeg.
You put
SVT.
Thanks for the warning.
You guys will hear me. Loud and clear.
Thanks, mate.
Oh, really? Yeah. Just. No better, no worse.
All right, here we have Brett Kingman, the famous burger. The famous burger. Hey, Burks, can you take us through your guitar rig for the James Reyne Plays Australian Crawl?
Sure, there's not much to it. Just point it sort of. That's better.
So take us through your rig for this James Reyne
Tour. Basically, the amp is an XFX 2. From which I can dial pretty much any amp I need, and that's the controller for it, a MIDI controller for it, the MFC 101. Australian Crawl is based largely on single coil strung, single coil guitars, like a Strat, and I think Simon used to use some sort of Marshall Plexi and Treble Booster and an Echo Plex, perhaps, not much else, maybe a chorus and a flanger. So I've tried to remain as true as I can in terms of what I dial up here to those sounds. So I've dialed a 50 watt Plexi and a couple of Vox AC30s and some Echo Plex delays, and that's pretty much it. I've got a custom shop 56 Strat here with Mick Wheelie's pickups in it, and I've got a Red House Telecaster over there that is sharing the duties, and it's fantastic as well. It's got Chris Klein's Epic 52 pickups in it, which are basically the old broadcaster Telecaster pickups. They're nice and MIDI and honky, got a bit of punch.
And what's that bridge? That's a nice looking bridge.
That's a Joe Barden compensator Telecaster bridge, and it's compensated because the saddles have got indents here to get better intonation, and there's a little gap cut out there so you don't cut your hand as you would normally on these old ashtray bridges.
Sweet.
The body's a little bit thicker than a normal Telecaster body, just about a quarter inch or something. So it's got a bit more girth, but it's very light. Built by Tony Nasrallah in Melbourne, actually, here. And that's it. There's not much more to it. I run the Axe FX directly to front of house and then back through some wedges. And I control the wahs and other synthy sort of things with that Mission Expression pedal. It's all connected by a Cat 5 to the Axe FX. It's pretty damn simple.
Nice.
Unless it goes wrong, and then it's really, really bad. But I do have a contingency plan, which I'll show you what it is. It's interesting.
I wouldn't be wearing your guitar for a while.
If it all goes to shit, I've got this Analog Alien Rumble Seat pedal, which is drive and reverb and delay. That would go to a bassman or another sort of Fender amp or whatever.
What? I want that. That's f***ing awesome.
It is, actually. It sounds amazing. And so that's my backup.
Wow.
Right there.
Drive, reverb.
Plessy drive, reverb, and delay.
No, oh, you've been holding out. I want those f***ing things.
Well, like, you can get one from New York. And
Just shoe it into one case.
Cool.
That's it, fellas. So now I get to pack it all up. Yeah. Bless you.
Bless you.
You alright?